Hello children, yesterday we have discussed about the terms, important terms which are used in the genetics. So today we will go through the Mendel's experiments. So I told you that Mendel did experiments in a very systematic way. So at a time, first he selected one character at a time and did the experiments, and second time he selected two characters together and did the experiment, and then third time three characters together and did the experiment. Like this he conducted experiment in a systematic order way. So let us see his experiment where he considered only one character. That is, at a time when he did the cross, he concentrated only on one character among the seven character. That is, he considered how that one character will get inherited from one generation to the other generation. So that is inheritance of a single gene. That is inheritance of a single gene, which is also called monohybrid cross. What do you mean by monohybrid cross? It is a cross which involve breeding between two individuals which differ in one pair of contrasting characters. That is called the monohybrid cross. So it will be asked for 3 marks or 5 marks in the annual exam. It is already asked question. Now let us see. Mendel first took one character at a time. Here let us take the character height. So in the height, two contrasting characters are there, that is tall and the dwarf. So these factors which will control these, that is the genes which will control these characters, if they are dominant, then it is indicated by capital T, capital T. If they are recessive, then it is indicated by the lower case of the dominant character, or you can say small letter of the dominant character, that is small t, small t. So these here we will write two times because P plant is a diploid. So every character controlling genes are present in twice, that is two times on a homologous on a chromosome. So that is why we will write the genes two times. So first Mendel, what did he do? He selected the pure line plants. He selected the tall plant and the dwarf plant as a parent. So I wrote here parent. And these parent produce the gametes, pollen grains and the ova. When the pollination, hybridization or cross pollination you can say, when the pollination was done in the F1 generation, in the first filial generation, he got all tall plants. Even though they are hybrid, because we are considering two contrasting characters, the dwarf character did not got expressed in the F1 generation. Then he followed his third step, that is he self-pollinated the progenies of F1 generation to get the next generation. What is next generation? It is second filial generation. So here he did selfing. So what do you say for this? Selfing or inbreeding. Selfing. So he did self-pollination. Let me write clearly. So F1 into F1 he did, and this is called selfing. So when he did selfing among the F1 generation, he got two types of gametes, because F1 is a heterozygous. They are heterozygous tall. As the plants are heterozygous, they produce two types of gametes. 50% of the gametes were having capital T and other 50% were having the small t. Then we can show the progenies by using the checkerboard, or you can say Punnett square, just to avoid the confusion. So how many gametes are there? Those many rows and columns you have to draw. And here on one line you have to take the female gametes, and on the other line you have to take the male gametes. And there you have to write the gametes like capital T, small t, capital T, small t. Then you have to cross them and write the result here. So when you cross the capital T with a capital T, you'll get capital T, and it is a homozygous condition. And as both the genes are dominant, and this seed will express the tall character. And here capital T, small t, capital T, small t, it is heterozygous, and in the presence of the dwarf character, only tall will get expressed. This is heterozygous tall. That means this gamete, that is this pollen grain, has equal opportunity to combine with these two ova. Then this small t crosses with the capital T, small t. It is also heterozygous tall, and small t will get combined with the small t. It is homozygous dwarf. So these results we will get when you take all the F2 plants as 100%. So here you will get 75% of the plants are tall, and only 25% of the plants were dwarf. And here, see, while writing the genotype of the progeny, always you have to write the dominant one first, the dominant gene first, and then the recessive gene you have to write. That is about the writing. Now when you consider the phenotypic ratio, when you take the phenotypic ratio, what do you mean by phenotype? It is the external appearance of the progenies. So here three plants, that is 75% of the plants are tall. 75% of the plants are tall, and 25% of the plants were dwarf. So if you write in the form of ratio, you will get phenotypic ratio 3:1. Genotypic ratio, when you see here, you will get 25% homozygous tall, 50% heterozygous tall, and 25% homozygous dwarf you will get. That is in the ratio of 1:2:1. So this is the genotypic ratio. So these were the results of monohybrid cross. Let me just repeat once again. What do you mean by monohybrid? A hybrid which differ in one character. What do you mean by monohybrid cross? It is a cross which involve two parents which differ in one character. It is also called single gene inheritance, because you are considering only one gene which is controlling one character. So Mendel first, he considered all the seven characters and did the same experiment. But here we are considering one character, that is height. It has got two alternate characters, tall and the dwarf. And here the gene controlling the tall character we have indicated with the capital T, and the genes controlling the dwarf character we have indicated with the small t and the small t. Genes we wrote two times we wrote as the pea plant is diploid. Now, so Mendel's experimental procedure. First, he took the pure line plants as a parent. So here we took parent as tall and the dwarf. So these parents produced gametes. As they are homozygous, they produced similar type of gametes. When they will get hybridized, or when we do cross pollination, you know how he did hybridization, that is through emasculation. And when he got the F1 generation, he got all tall plants. There is no trace of dwarf plant. The dwarf character got hidden. So he got all tall hybrids. When to get the F2 generation, he selfed the F1 progenies, that is F1 into F1. So F1, when we take as a parent, as they are heterozygous, they produce two types of gametes. That is 50% of the gametes were having the capital T, and 50% of the gametes were having the small t. So these, when they pollinate, when self-pollination was done, you'll get 75% tall and 25% dwarf plants. This we have indicated here with the Punnett square. With the knowledge of mathematics, you can write it very easily. So every gamete independently has got the chance of combining with the other gamete. Equal chance nature will give. We are not controlling. He did not control here the experiment. So when you take the genotypic ratio, when you take sorry when you take first phenotypic ratio, here you'll get 3:1, that is 75% were tall and 1% were dwarf. The character which got hidden in the F1 generation got expressed in the F2 generation. When you take the genotype, here you will get 1 homozygous tall, 2 heterozygous tall and 1 homozygous dwarf. When you take in the percentage form, 25% tall, 25% dwarf, homozygous, and 50% heterozygous tall you will get. So that is the ratio 1:2:1. So Mendel performed experiment by considering all the 7 characters carefully, and every time he got the same result. By careful study and analysis, 2 principles he framed, 2 laws he framed. That is the law of dominancy and law of segregation. What do you mean by law of dominance? So here when we are taking 2 different types of parent, our same character, of course the character is height only, but one is tall, one is dwarf. What he got in F1 generation? Only tall character. Where the dwarf character went? It got unexpressed, it got hidden, it got suppressed by the presence of a tall character. So the character which got expressed in the F1 generation, he considered that character as dominant. So this is the law of dominance. What is law of dominance? Among the 2 genes, among the 2 factors, one will get expressed under heterozygous condition in F1 generation, and that character which is expressed in F1 generation is called as dominant, and other one which is hidden, which went unexpressed, is called the recessive character. So this is the dominant gene. The gene which is expressed is the dominant gene, and the character is the dominant character, and this phenomena is called dominance. So that is the law of dominance. Now second law is law of segregation, or you can say law of purity of gametes. Law of purity gametes, what do you mean by law of purity of gametes or law of segregation? See here, a pair of factors are brought together in a hybrid, right? A pair of genes which control 2 alternative characters are brought together in a hybrid, fine, and these got separated independently. They got separated during the formation of gametes. And you know that gametes in a diploid plants are formed due to the meiosis. So each gene, each gamete gained 1 gene, a haploid case. You know that the diploid organisms produces haploid gametes, and each haploid gamete will be having 1 gene. So the genes which are combined in the F1 generation got separated, and each gamete got inherited 1 gene, 1 factor. So this is called the law of segregation. That is the separation of genes during the formation of the gametes is called the law of segregation, or it is also called law of purity of gametes. What is law of purity of gametes? Each gamete is getting only 1 trait, 1 character controlling gene. That is, gamete is pure for a particular character. Even though both the genes are present together in a hybrid, in a F1 generation, the dominant gene will not contaminate the tall gene, or you can say tall gene did not get contaminated when it is present with the tall gene. So these 2 principles Mendel framed after the careful study of the monohybrid or inheritance of a single gene. Let me write just the laws. Let us see the definitions. So here the law of dominance I wrote. When 2 contrasting characters are present in a single individual, that is hybrid, any one character is expressed. And that character which is expressed is called dominant, and the other one is recessive. You have to write like this. Or you can say in the heterozygous condition, whichever character is expressed, that is the dominant one. Now second law is the law of segregation. I told this is also called law of purity of gametes. So whenever a pair of factors for a character is brought together in a hybrid, whenever a pair of factors controlling a pair of character are brought together in a hybrid, they separate or segregate during the formation of the gamete. So this is called law of segregation. This is also called law of purity of gametes, as gametes receive only one factor of a character. That is, gametes are pure for a particular character. That is the law of segregation. So same now how I did monohybrid cross, that is the inheritance of a single gene, you have to practice by yourself by taking other example which I am giving now in the animals. Like you have to cross between two guinea pigs, they are the mammals, small rat like mammals. So cross between two guinea pigs whose coat color is black and white. Black color is the dominant and white color is the recessive. So that you have to do, and same pattern how I did previously, that only you have to follow and you'll get the same result. The analysis, the phenotypic ratio, genotypic ratio, everything will be same. So just I will write the character. Coat, what is the coat color? Black and white. Black and white. Fine. Black, it is dominant. The hint always will be given. So black is dominant, so we will indicate that with the capital B, capital B. I already told the first letter of the dominant characters you have to use to indicate the gene, and that too with the capital letter. And white is the recessive one. You have to use the small letter of the dominant character, and rest you can do by yourself. Hope you can do. And these two laws you have to by heart. Now let us know the different types of crosses, that is the back cross and the test cross. Now let us see the next monohybrid, back cross and the test cross. Let me first take the back cross. Back cross. So what do you mean by back cross? The F1 hybrids are back crossed with any one of the parent. Maybe dominant parent or the recessive parent. Let me write F1 progenies. F1 progenies are crossed. Crossed with any one of the parent. Any one of the parent. And here just to have more and more parental characters. To have more and more parental characters in the progenies. More and more parental characters in the progenies. So that is the back cross. What I told, F1 hybrids are back crossed with the parent, any one parent. So let me take the case. So first case, so F1 is crossed with any one parent. Now let me take the F1. Let me consider it as a parent. Now second generation, or next time when we are crossing, the first we will consider that as a parent. The first generation is considered as a parent. So here F1 hybrid, which is heterozygous tall, I have taken, and the dominant tall parent I have taken. Both are tall. So gametes are always haploid. So these diploid genes, just you have to separate. Genes are to separate and write. So as it is homozygous, it produces the similar kind of gamete, and it produces the different kinds of gametes. Now progenies. So here you have to draw the Punnett square. Let me draw the Punnett square. Now capital T, small t, one side let me take as female, other side male. Capital T, capital T. So here we have to cross. This pollen will combine with the ova of this one, and this capital T, small t, capital T, capital T, capital T, small t. So here, as the presence of the dominant gene will express itself, here homozygous stall, heterozygous stall, homozygous stall, heterozygous stall. So all are tall. When you take the phenotypic ratio, when you take the phenotypic ratio, all are tall. All are tall. That is 4, you did not get any dwarf character only. So that is 4:0 you can write. And when you take the genotypic ratio, genotypic ratio. So here you will get 2 homozygous, that is 50% are homozygous tall, 1:1 ratio you will get. 50% are homozygous tall and 50% are heterozygous tall. Fine. So all are tall. When after crossing with the parent, when you get all the tall plants, so you will get all tall plants. So this is one case, and let me take another case, second case. When you cross F1 with other parent, that let me take the dwarf parent recessive. So let me take these as parent, capital T, small t, small t, small t, and they produces the gametes. They produces the gametes of the F1, as it is heterozygous, produces 2 kinds of gametes, and recessive parent produce similar type of gamete as it is homozygous. And now the progenies, what kind of progeny you will get? Just let us show that with the Punnett square. One side male and one side female you have to draw, you have to take as a gametes. Now cross capital T, small t, capital small t, small t, capital T, small t, small t, small t. I told always when you will come across the capital and the small, that is the dominant and the recessive character, always write the dominant character first. So here also I did the same, and let me write the phenotype of these. It is a dwarf one. It is again heterozygous tall, homozygous dwarf. When you take the phenotypic ratio, so phenotypic ratio, phenotypic ratio, when you take, so 50% of them are tall and 50% of them are dwarf. And when you take the genotypic ratio, genotypic ratio, again you have got 50% heterozygous tall and 50% homozygous dwarf. So let me write in percent. That is 50% are tall and 50% are dwarf. So when you take in the form of genes, heterozygous tall and 50% were homozygous dwarf. So this is the result. Now what we did? We did back cross. What do you mean by back cross? Crossing the F1 progenies with any one of the parent. And you know that parent, we have taken a pure line parent, that is pure tall and pure dwarf. In first case, we have crossed the F1 hybrid with the homozygous tall parent. So when you cross with the homozygous tall parent, all you are going to get the tall plants only. Tall plants only. And here when you see the genotypic ratio, 50% of them are homozygous tall and 50% of them are heterozygous tall. On the other hand, when you cross the F1 progeny with the recessive parent, that is dwarf parent, you will get 50% of them tall and 50% of them are dwarf. Fine. And genotype also, 50% of them are heterozygous tall and 50% of them are homozygous dwarf. So this is called the back cross, and usually I told you that the back cross are done to gain or to have more and more parental characters in the progeny. In the plants, if the parental characters are good, the back crosses we will do to improve the characters in the progeny. That is to continuously that progeny will inherit more and more parental characters. Among these, when the F1 is crossed with the recessive parent, so here we will be knowing whether the F1 progeny or the hybrid which is under test is homozygous or heterozygous. This kind of cross is called test cross. It is a 3-mark question which is asked in the annual exam. Let me take that test cross separately. Let me explain test cross now. Now let us see the test cross. What do you mean by test cross? It is a method for identifying the genotype of unknown individual. It is a method by using which we will be coming to know the genotype of an unknown individual. Usually in the case of Mendel, he used this to know whether the F1 is homozygous or heterozygous. So here the unknown we will take as F1 progeny, and then we will cross this with the homozygous recessive parent. So let us see the test cross. So parent, what we have to take? We have to take the F1 and then we have to cross with its recessive parent. You have to cross with the recessive parent. So F1 is capital T small t and the recessive parent is small t small t. Now gametes, what kind of gamete does it produce? So as the F1 is heterozygous, it produces capital T small t. During Mendel time, he was not knowing. During his time, the technologies were not so advanced. Even the inventions were at elementary level. So the technology was not so advanced and he was not knowing whether F1 is hybrid or not. But performing this experiment, he came to know that those plants have got both the traits, both the factors controlling the characters. So that is the F1 capital T small t. And recessive, as they are homozygous, they produces similar type of gametes. Now we know, that is why we clearly are saying. Now the progenies, let me draw this side. Progenies. So let us draw the Punnett square. So one side male, one side female. Let me take here female, male. So as usual, you have to write the progenies and you have to write the phenotype. Whenever the dominant gene is present, that plant will express dominant character only due to the law of dominance. So here tall, heterozygous tall, tall, dwarf and dwarf. What is phenotypic ratio? Phenotypic ratio. So here you will get phenotypic ratio, that is 1:1. That is 50% tall and other 50% were dwarf. So what is genotypic ratio? Genotypic ratio is also 1:1. That is 50% you have heterozygous tall and 50% you have homozygous dwarf. So this is the test cross. Let me explain. What did I told? What do you mean by test cross? It is just a method to know the genotype of unknown individual. whatever unknown individual you have to take, you took, you have to cross that with the recessive parent. Here we have taken the F1 progeny. So F1 progeny, Mendel crossed with the recessive parent. So in the progenies, he saw 50% tall and 50% dwarf progenies. What did he concluded? He concluded that the progeny which is under test is heterozygous for a given character. That is why we got both the characters, that is tall and the dwarf. That is the given, the unknown given individual is heterozygous. Suppose if the given individual, this one is tall, homozygous tall, then we will get all tall plants only in the test cross. If it is dwarf, then you will get all dwarf plants only. That means what you have to consider, if we get both types of progenies in the test cross, then what we have to understand, the progeny, the individual which we have taken for the test is heterozygous for that particular character, heterozygous in condition for a given character. Suppose if you get only one type character. Suppose if you have taken capital T and crossed with small t, all you will get tall. So then it is homozygous. That is the individual which we have taken for the test is homozygous in condition. Homozygous for that particular character. For what character? For tall character. And if it is dwarf, then also it is homozygous for the dwarf character. Like this, we can analyze the individual which is under test, which we are considering for the test, is whether it is homozygous for that particular character or it is heterozygous for that particular character. So this is about the test cross, and Mendel performed test cross for all the seven contrasting characters, for all the seven characters which